squares, grids, and cubes in two-point perspective. We can easily make rectangles in two-point perspective, but what if we want to make accurate squares and cubes? How do we make sure our sides are all equal length in perspective? I'll cover two methods, using the diagonal vanishing point and using measuring points. First up, how to use the diagonal vanishing point. We'll start with our cone of vision setup from the vanishing points with a cone of vision video. We just need the frame, the horizon line, and the 90 degree angle. Create a line that splits the 90 degree angle in half. I'm calling it the 45 degree line. Where it crosses the horizon line, that's the diagonal vanishing point, or DVP, also known as the 45 degree measuring point, or 45 degree reference point, or 45 degree vanishing point. I'm going with diagonal vanishing point, DVP. When we rotate the 90 degree angle, the 45 degree line follows, and the diagonal vanishing point moves along the horizon line. But what is it for? Here's a square grid floor in 3D. If you draw diagonally through the squares, connecting the corners like this, they all head for that diagonal vanishing point. We can use this to make our squares and square grids. Squares with the DVP. So we've used the 90 degree angle and the 45 degree line to determine our vanishing points and the DVP. For a square, draw guidelines from the right and left vanishing points to mark your first corner. I'm using gray for my vanishing point guidelines. Let's draw the first edge of the square along the left VP guide. From the tip of that edge, draw a guide back to the right vanishing point. Use a different color to draw a guide from the diagonal vanishing point to your first corner. I'm using blue. Where the blue diagonal line crosses the last gray guide, that's another corner. Draw a line from the left vanishing point to and through that new corner. Now we have what we need to make our square, with all sides equal in perspective. Square grid with the DVP. We can continue from there to make a square grid. Draw a diagonal line from the DVP to the new corner, where the line from the DVP crosses the lines from the vanishing points, those are corners. Draw lines from the vanishing points through these corners. Alternate between drawing new diagonal guides and lines from the vanishing points to build a grid, like this. Here's how our grid compares to the 3D square grid. Looks good. There's another method that has some extra powers, using measuring points. Mark the length between the left vanishing point and the station point. Rotate the length from the LVP up to the horizon line. That's where we put the left measuring point, or LMP. So the distance between the left vanishing point and the station point is the same as the distance between the left vanishing point and the left measuring point. Do the same for the right side. Mark the length between the right vanishing point and the station point. Rotate it from the right vanishing point up to the horizon line. That marks the right measuring point, or RMP. These measuring points can help us make a perfect square, a square grid, and a cube with all equal sides. Notice that the right measuring point is on the left and the left measuring point is on the right. This can be confusing. Squares with measuring points. Draw guidelines from the vanishing points to the front corner of your square. Draw the first edge of your square. Let's begin with the left side. Put a horizontal line on the point closest to the camera. This is our measuring line. Draw a guide from the left measuring point through the end point of your edge to the measuring line. I'll use blue for lines from my measuring points. This gives us the length of our edge if it was flat in front of us and not foreshortened. Mirror that length to measure the other side of the square. Draw a blue measuring guide from here to the right measuring point. This tells us how far to draw our next edge. Now use the vanishing points to finish the rest of the square. Super. Cubes with measuring points. To make a cube, rotate the measuring line 90 degrees to get the height of our cube. Draw that front vertical edge. Make guides through the top of this edge to the vanishing points. Draw the vertical left and right edges of the cube. Connect your stuff. Make a guide from the right top corner to the left vanishing point. And make another one from the left top corner to the right vanishing point. Draw that back vertical edge. Connect your stuff. And there's a cube. Here's how it compares to a 3D cube. Wonderful. Square grids with measuring points. To draw the grid, duplicate the measuring line and make more units on both sides. Draw a gray line from the right vanishing point through the center hatch mark of the measuring line. Draw blue guides from the right measuring point that pass through the hatch marks. Where the blue guides cross the gray line, those are corner points. Draw gray lines through these corners from the left vanishing point. Now for measuring guides from the other side. Draw blue guides from the left measuring point that pass through the hatch marks of the measuring line. Where these new blue guides cross this gray line, that's where our new set of corner points will be. It's important that we're looking at this grid line that passes through the center hatch mark of the measuring line. Like before, draw gray lines through these intersection points from the right vanishing point. And there is a grid. Here's how our grid compares to the 3D square grid. Super.